And we're now joined by PBA Party List Representative Margarita Nograles. She authored the House resolution urging the NTC to suspend the operations of SMNI. Good morning to you, Representative Nograles.
Good morning, Ms. Karen. Hello.
So there's the House resolution to suspend the operations, and there's also a resolution to revoke its franchise. So okay, where are we when it comes to both resolutions?
Yes, to clarify lang, Ms. Karen, so the resolution that I filed is simply to urge NTC to suspend muna their operations. Okay. Essentially, since NTC was the one who granted the permits and the licenses, while we are looking into the violations of their franchise. Parang suspend po muna natin, which is within the power of NTC. That's why the resolution is simply to urge. The House bill naman po that was filed by another congressman is for already a different
for revocation.
Yes, because of what has been transpiring. Iba naman po yung resolution ko. Iba rin po yung House bill that was filed by another congressman, Congressman Gutierrez.
Okay. All right. Now that's clear. But what is the status of both resolutions now? For example, your resolution to urge the NTC is in effect, no, calling on the NTC,
yes,
right, to act. That's it.
Yes.
But the resolution of the other congressman, I know it's one rider party list representative Gutierrez, is to revoke, right? Correct. Revoke,
yes,
the franchise. But what is the sentiment in the lower house?
So with the resolution that I filed for, it was already adopted by the House. So since it's been adopted by the House and there was a voice vote already on this, then it's now up to NTC to act on it because it's well within their power with the separation,
yeah,
of powers. In terms of the House bill that was filed by Representative Gutierrez, we will have to go through the hearing based on that, on the revocation, into looking into the various violations of the franchise itself already as part, okay, of our House duty.
All right, I'm curious, so you can clarify this. Did you author the suspension of the SMNI franchise?
I did not author the bill on the suspension, on the revocation.
Yes.
I authored the resolution to urge NTC na parang kumbaga, teka lang,
right muna,
may mga violations tayo nakikita dito, not just on the franchise. Unti-unti po natin nakikita, hindi lang pula sa franchise, pati po sa mga other government agencies with KBP, mukhang SEC.
Yeah.
Teka muna, suspend din po muna natin habang tinitingnan po natin.
Based on the hearings, do you believe that SMNI has violated their franchise?
Well, we have yet to see, and nakikita natin that they have.
In what way?
Mukhang
may mga specific.
Yes. If you watch the previous hearing, I've laid down through a PowerPoint presentation the violations on Section 4, Section on the misinformation, yeah, deliberate information. At nakita naman po natin na...
Go ahead and detail it, Representative.
Sure.
Can you detail the violations and from the sections, move it to layman's terms?
Sige po. Parang isige, titiktok ko na lang po ito.
Necessarily.
Pero sa Section 4 on the willful misinformation, no, deliberate misinformation, there's already a violation to Section 4 sa parangkisa po. Which inamin naman po sa first hearing na hindi po validated nga po yung sinabi ng one of the hosts, mm-hmm, sa kanyang sinabi live. And for the during the first hearing also, the Secretary General also disputed the amount that was stated. Sinabi naman po doon na hindi naman po nagtutugma yung amount doon. So, meron talagang misinformation dito, which is a violation of Section 4. The violation on Section 10, nalabas naman po that the controlling interest, when they transferred it from the Pastor Tibulo, you know, in 2022, when the franchise was still in effect, and transferred to a certain brother, Marlon Acobo, walang prior approval in Congress, which is a violation of Section 10 on the first sentence of Section 10 of their franchise. And the second sentence of Section 10 of their franchise, should there be any transfer of controlling interest, kailangan ng report within 60 days from doing so. And hindi po nila ginawa. Section 11 naman po, after 29 years of existence po, they did not do the requirement on the dispersal of ownership, meaning hindi sila naggumawa ng public offering. What they reported was they did this through a cooperative, which is not even mentioned in their franchise. And they just reported it to Congress. And I emphasize, hindi nga lang po report or even asking Congress na sinasabi po during the hearing, they were waiting for a reply from Congress if they could do that. Which that report did not have a question, waiting for a reply from Congress. At the same time, the last sentence of that report was they already implemented that. Mm-hmm. And even so, nasabihin po na wala pong timeline. In 29 years of existing, they only tried to comply in the last 2 years. And the dispersal of that ownership sa cooperative, let's say, okay, may dispersal po, may public offering, no? 0.16% lang po. 1%, not even 30% of what they're mandated to do. And in the last hearing, lumabas po that iba po ang kanilang sinubmit officially sa GIS nila sa SEC and sa sinubmit po nila sa Congress as part of their repertorial requirements. And if mali po yung sinubmit na repertorial requirements po sa Congress, there's a violation na naman na nakita po natin on Section 12. So, unting-unti po natin nakikita nagkakalabagan sa batas. Kaya nga po, parang suspendin po muna natin kasi the more that we talk about it, the more na nakikita natin and the more that we see even more violations not within their franchise with the KBP code. And they only withdrew a day before the first hearing, which is December 4, 2023. So lahat po ng mga ginawa nila prior to that does not erase the fact that there was a violation. There's a violation also with the MTRCB. May violation na rin po na mukhang nakikita natin with SEC with their amendments of the Articles of Incorporation to a corporation sole. So habang, di ba, ganito po yung nangyayari. Baka kailangan po muna natin suspindihin yung, ay, sasabihin sa NTC, tingnan nyo to. Kasi mukhang kailangan yung suspindihin muna.
All right, okay. I'll catch on to some points you mentioned.
Sure.
There is no love lost here for SM&I. Okay, I'm gonna approach
yes.
this. And I'll take what you said. This isn't about TikTok. When you say stay in layman's terms, this is for viewers to get behind the technicality of issues. So number one, when it comes to them giving the figure of the speaker spent 1.8 billion pesos for travels, clearly that was wrong. They didn't have the evidence to show it. No, a journalist is asked to show evidence, right? And he did say that the source was someone from the Senate. Siguro kwentuhan, right? And
yes,
perhaps the commentator could have been more responsible in that sense. But at the end of the day, whether you like the commentator or not, he is still protected by the SOTO law not to reveal a source.
Yes.
Without, do you agree?
Well, lumabas po yun during the hearing, and I do understand the SOTO law. But there is an exception in the SOTO law that when
Which
it comes
what?
To national security, diba po?
But that, what makes that national security? I mean, you know, I'm calling out a public
yes.
official, regardless if it were the speaker or not,
yes.
on trips spent. And the reason I know this is because radio commentators from mainstream media have done it with past presidents.
Yes.
Hindi naman sila pinatawag sa hearing.
Yes po. I understand that.
Because
so
what makes, I mean, on this particular end, what makes Congress the editorial chief of a free press?
So, okay, with that, hindi naman po, sinabi ko naman po rin when I did the sponsorship speech on this, this is not a oppression of the freedom of the press. No. But kung meron silang mga violations, they have to be accountable for that.
I agree. I absolutely agree. I'm not, this is not about you.
Yes.
This is really just as a whole.
Yes.
This is as a whole, right?
Mm-mm. Mm-mm.
If the commentator didn't hit on the speaker, would Congress have acted? If he, let's say, hit an opposition person, somebody irrelevant to the supermajority,
yes,
would Congress have come to the defense of the free press or disinformation?
But this stemmed from various resolutions na po. No.
Yeah, but
and
no, my answer,
time,
answer my question.
Yes.
Would the supermajority in Congress, as I say, I have no love lost here,
yes,
for SMNI,
yes,
but this is a matter of principle. If
yes,
it was
po,
not the speaker who was hit, would congressmen have acted in the same manner?
Like I said, so hindi lang po naman yun kasi yung nandun sa resolution po. Meron din pong pagtatama sa mga, may mga ibang resolutions po rin na na-file on this red tagging, on this misinformation.
Okay. So
and
let's
all
talk about red tagging. I'm curious. The irony of this is SMNI's 2019 franchise, but
yes,
the franchise was renewed in 2019.
Yes,
okay,
po.
Your brothers sponsored the franchise renewal of,
yes,
SMNI.
Yes.
Right? So we're talking,
yes,
about now Secretary Carlo Nograles when he was in Congress and Jericho Nograles. They sponsored the SMNI renewal.
Yes.
Didn't they spot the violations before they sponsored it?
Well, when you sponsor something and when Congress does something, syempre it's a privilege that's given, right? This has nothing to do with who has authored it. Now it has to do with binigyan kayo ng privilege. You're supposed to be following.
But I agree. I have no debate on that.
Yes.
The issue I'm asking is, I agree with your principles completely. So it leads me to this question. Isn't franchise revocation or renewal really just used at times? It's about who sits in power.
Mm-mm.
Because, I mean, let me move back. I've asked this.
Mm-mm.
ABS situation is different in the sense,
yes,
that the franchise expired. But
mm-mm,
that's a mainstream media network that it could have been renewed.
Mm-mm.
But the powers that be didn't want.
Mm-mm.
So ang tanong ko nga ito, if these violations have been going on, weren't these spotted by the very congressmen, one, two, your brothers, and the other colleagues you work with today?
Yes.
Did they,
well,
spot this? In other
during
words,
that time,
the violations were going on, and oh, let's just renew them anyway.
Well, I cannot speak on behalf of the past Congress, but what we're looking into now is that there are violations that's happening. And wala po akong magagawa kung sila po, di ba, nag-sponsor po na to at pinasa po ng past Congress. And I'm not saying anything that mali yung ginawa ng past Congress to do that. It's within their right to pass it. We're looking into what's happening now and we are seeing violations. So let's not get confused here na iba po yung, okay, in the past Congress, this was renewed, yes. But right now, we're looking into violations now because there are violations that we are seeing.
Mm-mm. And of the violations, what is the strongest? What is the strongest violation that would merit a revocation? Because to comment on, he's wrong. Okay, clearly he was wrong in the facts, but that doesn't alone constitute a revocation. Because
yes,
there's so many commentators that are wrong, right?
Yes.
It happens,
yes,
right? So,
mm-hmm,
ang tanong ko, what is the strongest and clearest violation of the franchise?
Well, hindi po nagsisimula ang paghihear po with regard to the revocation. So wag natin pangunahan po because that's another hearing. What we did and what we adopted is a resolution to urge NTC because of the violations, that possible violations on their franchise. So that would be for another hearing naman po on the House bill that was filed on the revocation.
And I think another issue for many people today is you have Congress now fighting against this information. But during the past administration, this information was actually, it was tolerated.
I can't speak for the past congressman. Right?
So you have the same people angry with this information today, but it was used against journalists, opposition lawmakers. This information was used for the past 6 years, was tolerated by Congress.
That's the previous Congress, Ms. Karen, and I can only say, really, with regard to the resolution that I filed, that we adopted. As per that, I cannot really speak on behalf of the other congressmen and the past Congress po, as much as wala po talaga, hindi po ako abogado po nila. And I'm only just one vote in Congress. And simply, dito lang po tayo sa resolution ko, you know, even with a heavy heart at taga-Davao din naman po ako, na yun yung lumalabas. I cannot be silent naman po kung may nakikita tayo mga violations. Kaya nga po, suspendin po muna natin, which is within the power of NTC. At wala po kami magagawa dyan. As regard to the revocation, we have yet to see what will transpire in the hearings to come regarding that.
All right. On that note, I want to thank you so much for joining us today. Thank you. And thank you for being a good sport. Thank you. All right.
Thank you.
Okay. We have Congresswoman Margarita Nograles. Thank you.